Blessed Virgin Mary and the Holy Trinity. Today we are going to see God, the Holy Ghost and the Blessed Virgin Mary. God the Holy Ghost became fruitful through the Blessed Virgin Mary, whom he espoused from all eternity. The Holy Ghost had espoused the Blessed Virgin Mary as his spouse. It was with her, in her, and of her that he produced his masterpiece, God Made Man. In the same way, with Mary, in Mary, and of Mary, that he produces even today, until the end of this world, the members of this adorable head, Jesus Christ, the mystical body's members, all baptized Catholics. For this reason, the more he finds Mary, who is his indispensable spouse, in a soul, the more powerful and effective he becomes in producing Jesus in that soul. The more he finds Mary in a soul, the more powerful he becomes in producing Jesus in that soul. This is a mystery of grace. Mystery of grace. The words of Scripture says, "The Lord possessed me in the beginning of his ways." The Lord means God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. I was set up from eternity and of old before the earth was made. The depths were not as yet, and I was already conceived. Neither had the fountains of waters as yet sprung out. The mountains with their huge bulk had not yet been established. Before the hills I was brought forth, he had not yet made the earth, nor the rivers, nor the poles of the world. When he prepared the heavens, I was present with him. When with a certain law he enclosed the depths, when he established the sky above and poised the fountains of waters, when he compassed the sea with his bounds and set a law to the waters, I was with him forming all things, and was delighted every day playing before him at all times. He that shall find me shall find life, and shall have salvation from the Lord. These are the words of Our Lady found in the Scripture. In the Scripture, Proverbs chapter 8, Blessed Virgin Mary is the spouse of the Holy Ghost. How? You are going to see a little deeper now. Blessed Virgin Mary's whole being was overshadowed by the Holy Ghost from all eternity. Not only at that time of Annunciation, Though the Holy Scripture does not tell us much about the Blessed Virgin, it is difficult that her first and last mention in the New Testament, first mention and the last mention about Our Lady in the New Testament. First one was the Annunciation, the last one the Pentecost. This shows us the relation with the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost shall come upon thee, and the power of the Most High shall overshadow thee. That was at the time of Annunciation. Then at the time of Pentecost, they went up into an upper room, which was called Cenacle, and were persevering with one mind in prayer with the woman, Our Lady, the Mother of Jesus. And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost. So the intervention of the Holy Ghost was always with Our Lady, from the beginning of the Gospel to the end. The inseparable union of the Blessed Virgin Mary with the Holy Ghost. Through the Holy Ghost, the Blessed Virgin brings forth Christ in souls and forms them saints. In any man, if any man has Jesus Christ formed in his heart, he can boldly say, "It is thanks to the Blessed Virgin Mary that I possess Jesus, who is her fruit." This is another mystery, mystery of grace, not known to the sinners, very little known to the predestinate, those who go to heaven. All those who go to heaven are hidden in the womb of the Blessed Virgin, whether they accept it or not, whether they are conscious of it or not. And while they are on earth and protected, nourished, cared for and developed by this good Holy Mother, until the day she brings them forth to a life of glory after death. Even those who do not practice devotion to our Blessed Mother, Our Lady takes care of them, because Our Lady is rightly Mother of all human beings. Yes, even those who do not want to love her, she takes care of them. God the Holy Ghost wishes to fashion His chosen ones in and through the Blessed Virgin Mary. We are all in the world striving for perfection. And this perfection is fashioned in and through the Blessed Virgin Mary. He tells her, Holy Ghost tells her, "Take root in my elect." It's Old Testament, Ecclesiasticus 24. That means, let all your virtues take root in my chosen people. All her virtues must take root, that they may grow from strength to strength, and from grace to grace. Reproduce yourself in my chosen ones, the Holy Ghost tells the Blessed Virgin Mary, so that I may see in them the roots of your invincible faith, profound humility, total mortification, sublime prayers, ardent charity, firm hope and all your virtues. Yes. In order to possess in our soul the virtues, this is the way. You ask the Holy Ghost, the spouse of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to take root in our soul. If she takes root in our soul, the fullness of grace which she is will be also given to us according to our capacity. When Mary has taken root in a soul, what does happen? She produces in it wonders of grace which only she can produce. What she is going to do is to introduce souls into the light of God. That is her work. She introduces us, her children, into the light of God. As she did to the Fatima children. Blessed Virgin Mary alone can produce this grace because she alone is fruitful. Fruitful virgin who never had and never will have her equal in purity and fruitfulness. This purity and fruitfulness she possesses as an effect of her perfect conformity with the will of God and perfect union with the Holy Ghost. Now, this is the simple way for us to possess all the graces in our soul. Just ask the Holy Ghost, to ask the Blessed Virgin Mary to take root in us. It's a very simple devotion. If you wish to be filled with graces so that Satan may not come into your soul again, because your soul is filled with grace. We want that grace to be filled always. Our Lady must take root in us. That is a strong and filial devotion to the Blessed Virgin Mary. As the grace of filial devotion to the Holy Ghost, to the spouse, if you ask him fervently to ask our Blessed Mother to take root in our soul, it will happen immediately. Yeah. To make ourselves, see ourselves in God. Hence, together with the Holy Ghost, the Blessed Virgin Mary first produced the great thing that ever was or ever will be, a God-man. And then the grace of sanctification in God's children. Yes. The Holy Ghost produced the great thing, the God-man in her. And then the grace of sanctification in our own souls. She will consequently produce the marvels which will be seen in the latter times. We are in the latter times. Yes. This is the time in which Our Lady must take root in the hearts, in the souls of her children. In the last times there will be formation and education of great saints. I wish that this place becomes the center of making great saints in the latter times, because we have all the teachings of Jesus Christ, all the graces of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mount Carmel, in this place. Because of our filial devotion to the holy sacrifice of the Mass, the Blessed Sacrament, to all the sacraments which are observed here perfectly, 100%. That's why I want this place to be the center of formation and education of great saints. Our seminary should be that. Formation and education of great saints who will come at the end of the world as reserved to the Blessed Virgin Mary. Yes, we, the parents, the faithful, belonging to this Our Lady of Mount Carmel Parish, convent and seminary, we have a singular privilege to fulfill the time, end of times. For only this singular and wondrous Virgin can produce, in union with the Holy Ghost, singular and wonderful things. People do not know how much this place, the Lady of Mount Carmel, has that singular and wondrous privilege because of the graces given to us by the Holy Catholic teachings, sacraments, chiefly the Holy Sacrifice of the Mass. So we must know how privileged we are. We must learn to appreciate the grace given to us in this place. Pray for many faithful to come and sanctify themselves. Pray for these seminarians and for the future seminarians. They all must come here to become great saints through the Blessed Virgin Mary by the power of the Holy Ghost. I think that is enough for us today.